Dear CG thinkers, welcome. How to make really realistic procedural Rust? To tease you, here is what we are going to do. Personally, I have never been very satisfied with what I found on YouTube, and I hate the use of color ramps. I created a Rust node which does not use color ramps but only one color. This node is available in my Materializer add-on, and here is how to use it. Here we are in Blender with an incomplete material. Let's start by selecting the principal shader, press the F key and add a two-layer system. This first layer will be the metal and the second will be for the rust. I set the first layer to look like metal. I connect the iron node to the color input. This node is available in the Pi menu in the color submenu. I use a grunge 00 node that you can find in the grunge section of the Materializer library. I will let you look at the setting of the node and we go straight to its use. I use the result output to connect it to the color variation input to darken the metal according to the texture by decreasing the value slider. I also use the roughness output set between them 0.15 and 0.0.3. Finally, I connect the normal with a straight of the 0.15. That's it for the metal part. Let's go to the rust. The rust node is in the metal section of the library. Its use is extremely simple. Just connect the color output, roughness, and normal. Nothing else. It's very simple. And you notice that you setting up this node doesn't require a color ramp. You only have to specify one color. And this is where things get interesting. What's going to make this extremely convincing is how we are going to mix the two textures, the metal and the rust. The basis of bases is the use of a grunge 00 node by connecting the result output to the mask input of the mix layers node. Clearly, we are already on something nice. It looks good, but we can do better. The first thing I would like to do is to make sure that the rust appears on all edges of the model. To do this, I add an all edges node that I use with a grunge 4 node. I get very interesting mask that I will have to combine with the grunge 0 node that I'm currently using as mask. I mix the two masks together with a node lighten. This node is available in the Pi menu. By using the output of this node as a mask, we can see that indeed the rust appears now on all the edges of the model. It's really important to keep this in mind. When you make a texture, the texture has to interact with the model because the geometry influences the materials. And it's with that in mind that we're going to do one last thing to make the texture on the helmet even more convincing. If you look at rusted objects, You can see that the rust does not have quite the same color on the flat areas and on the edges. I suggest that you to use the edge mask output to modulate the color of the rust by making it a little darker in these areas. It may not look like much to you, but these last two steps have a lot to do with the consistency of the material, with the object to which it is applied. Now you can rust anything you want. If you can, don't hesitate to save this material to reuse it whenever you need it. That's the whole point of 3D. To capitalize on what you've already done. And it's especially true for materials. If you haven't already done, subscribe to continue to progress together. It's a real pleasure to share all this with you. You will find all the links in the descriptions to my networks, the Discord, and the online store for my add-ons. We will see you soon because we get tired of everything except learning. Bye bye.